1 of Canyon de Chelly, the Story of Its Ruins and People. Canyon de Chelly, the Story of Its Ruins and People by Zorro A. Bradley. Part 1. Discovery of the Ruins. Canyon de Chelly National Monument is located in the Red Rock Country of northeastern Arizona's High Plateau, near the center of the Navajo Indian Reservation. Included in its 131 square miles are three spectacular canyons, Canyon de Chelly, Canyon del Muerto, and Monument Canyon, and many ruins of long-deserted villages. Perched in alcoves and on high ledges along the sheer walled canyons, these villages are evidence of man's ability to adjust to a difficult environment using bare hands, simple Stone Age tools, and his own ingenuity. They stand as enduring monuments to the culture of the ancestors of the present-day Pueblo Indians of the southwestern United States. The ancestors of the Navajo Indians, who now live in the shadows of these deep canyons, came here long after the earlier people had left. Originally, the Navajos did not live in the canyon, but only passed through it on their yearly migrations. Today, some live here permanently, and their hogans are scattered along the sandy canyon floor, almost hidden by the thick growth of willows and cottonwoods, and detectable only by a column of smoke slowly rising from a cook fire or by the barking of dogs. Occasionally one may catch a glimpse of a brightly dressed woman working around the hogan, or of black-hatted men trotting their horses between the nearby trading post, cornfields, or peach orchards. A reserved and dignified people, they still live in the tradition of their fathers. The main canyon's name, De Chelly, stems from the Navajo word Tsegi, pronounced Tsegi or Tsegi, and meaning rock canyon, the name by which they know the canyon network. Two centuries of Spanish and English usage have corrupted both the form and pronunciation. Most people now pronounce it Da Chelly or De Chelly. The first Europeans to see the extensive ruins in Canyon de Chelly are unknown. A Spanish map of 1776 indicates its location, and other documents reveal that Spanish military expeditions sometimes passed through the neighborhood. In 1805, Spanish troops entered the canyon while trying to suppress Navajo raids. During the period of Mexican rule, 1821-46, a number of military expeditions against the Navajo invaded the Canyon de Chelly region. Though the ruins had not been described in writing, the area was fairly well known, and by 1846, when the Army of the West brought the region under United States control, there were many tall tales and rumors about the wonderful cities built in the cliffs. In 1849, the New Mexico territorial government found it necessary to request that a U.S. Army expedition be sent to subdue the Navajos. Lieutenant J. H. Simpson of the Topographical Engineers accompanied the troops. His journal, published in 1850, contained the first detailed account of some of the Canyon de Chelly ruins. After Simpson's visit, other military expeditions and a few civilian parties probably entered the canyons. No archaeological investigations were made, however, until 1882, when James Stevenson surveyed the area for the Smithsonian Institution, making sketches, photographs, and ground plans of 46 ruins in the two main canyons. Stevenson found two mummies in a rock shelter ruin in the northern canyon. Because of this find, the ruin is known as Mummy Cave, and Stevenson gave the canyon a Spanish name, Cañon de los Muertos, or Canyon of the Dead Men. The name has since been shortened to Del Muerto. Later, in 1882, Cosmos Mindeleff, also from the Smithsonian and a member of Stevenson's party, mapped the canyons and showed the locations of some of the larger ruins. Mindeleff's monumental architectural survey of the ruins of Canyon de Chelly was published in 1896, after two more visits. Much of our knowledge about material objects used by the early Puebloan inhabitants of the canyons comes from the work of the late Earl H. Morris, who excavated a number of the important cave sites in the 1920s. Since then, a comprehensive survey of the monument has been carried out by David L. DeHarpert for the Peabody Museum of Harvard University, and additional excavations have been conducted by National Park Service archaeologists. The principal ruins, White House. Within the National Monument are perhaps 800 prehistoric and historic Indian village sites representing various stages of Pueblo and later Navajo cultural development and spanning a period of about 1,800 years. The most interesting and important ruins are described below. White House. Located up the main canyon about 6 miles from Park Service headquarters, White House is one of the largest, best preserved, and most accessible ruins in the monument. Lieutenant J. H. Simpson described this ruin after his 1849 visit, calling it Casablanca, White House. It is also known by its Navajo name, Kininaakai, both names derived from a conspicuous white plastered wall in the upper portion. White House was constructed in two sections. One stands against the base of the cliff on the canyon floor, and the other is in a small cave immediately above. Mendeleev estimated that at one time the whole ruin contained as many as 80 rooms. Much of the lower building has probably been washed away by the stream nearby. A retaining wall now helps to prevent this, but evidence of about 60 rooms and 4 kivas, special ceremonial.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.